setting up your astrophotography gear is to always keep track of what you're doing. If you don't, you might end up forgetting something. One time, I forgot my Batinoff mask. Another time, I forgot my USB 3.0 cable. Tonight, but let me show you a cool trick. So we got these street lights here, that one and that one, and so when they're on, and that's due east, it's going to be shining light down my telescope. So I have these tripods here with weights to sort of anchor it down, and I'm going to be putting this curtain across.
Yeah.
All right. So this is my. You gotta walk back. This is the curtain I was telling you about. It'll close up. It's gonna block the lights from the street over behind me there, and there. And so the telescope right here.
This is really.
All right, guys. So we're gonna be collimating my Newtonian reflector. These three knobs here we can adjust in order to get this mirror. This secondary mirror right here to reflect the beam of light from the laser that comes out of here, out of the draw tube. This right here is the laser. Comes out of the draw tube, hits the secondary mirror, goes to the back, hits the primary mirror, and bounces back on its original path. So you want to get the laser into the center of the where my finger is, right there where that old donut is in the center. It looks like I got it spot on already. It's just a demonstration that this telescope and most Newtonian reflectors, they hold their collimation pretty long. So if you'll follow me to the back now. If you look in here, underneath here, there's a target that has the laser dot hitting a target there. If you just watch what happens when I move these. I could lock it so it lines up with the crosshairs as perfectly as possible. There it is. So now I've collimated the two mirrors, and these diffraction spikes that form the crosshairs line up with the target. So the mirrors are perfectly collimated now. All right, we got sunset underway. We got a little bit of hazy clouds going. It's supposed to be clearing up here. We got these dang street lights still. I haven't taken a rock to them yet, but we have my trusty light shield that I was putting together earlier, and it gets the job done for imaging in the front yard. So I've been using my newest camera. The latest addition to my gear is the ZWO ASI1600MM-Pro. I got the electronic filter wheel, and I'm still using my other ASI camera for auto guiding. I actually have a new focuser too. I don't know if you could tell. It's a GSO. And I love it. This thing is one of the greatest upgrades I've done to my gear so far. It's probably in the top five, I think. And here's the little jerry-rigged power box for the new camera's cooling capability. I just put a rubber band across here and wound it up a bit so that it's in there pretty. It'll wiggle around, but it's not going anywhere. And so this is my setup. Once we get the full darkness here, or as dark as it will get with these lights, we'll start taking some exposures. An RGB on the Great Globular Cluster in Hercules, M13. So stay tuned, folks, and we'll check it out. All right. All right, so we're in the excellent range here with the polar alignment. Here's the scope. You can see with my red light here, the Atlas Pro is on its side. The mount is all looking over at Phaeleh, which is just over that tree. And we got these cars driving by and the street lamps here. Whoa. But yeah, we'll be underway here shortly, folks. Kind of clearing up. Wishful thinking.